At this time, we'll call the member of the National Democratic Party of Ontario, MPP Jill Andrews.
Yes, my name is Jill Andrew, and I'm the MPP for Toronto St. Paul's. I'm also the culture critic, and it's with great honour that I stand here today with Sickle Cell Awareness Group of Ontario. In my riding, I met with one of our community members, Ulysse Gadere, the chair of the Sickle Cell Awareness Group of Ontario, and his friend Alvin Merchant. Both Ulysse and Alvin live with sickle cell anemia. Sickle cell disease was the first genetically recognized disease, and it is a severe, life-threatening illness that impacts red blood cells. Although many racialized people are impacted, including people of Arabian, Greek, and Italian descent, it disproportionately impacts Black and South Asian communities. That aside, it is important to acknowledge that sickle cell can impact a person of any race. This disease impacts the quality of one's life, it has destroyed families, and it is often fatal. As Ulysse and Alvin emphasized, from childhood, they've had to live one after painful day at a time, witnessing too many funerals of sicklers, undergoing too many hospitalizations, and frankly, hospital patient horror stories and surgeries, never knowing when a visit to the ER might be their last. Doctors on average receive only 8 hours of sickle cell training during 7 years of medical school. It is one of the most misunderstood, misdiagnosed, mistreated, under-researched, and underfunded diseases. Because sicklers may sometimes walk into the ER looking good on the outside, healthcare providers cannot see the war that's being waged on their bodies on the inside. By the time a doctor or a nurse decides to believe a patient's in crisis and is in debilitating pain, it can be too late. We must support the call of the Sickle Cell Awareness Group of Ontario. We must formally recognize June 19th as Sickle Cell Day across Ontario. We need a universal hospital protocol so that any sickler can go to a hospital knowing they will get the same standard of care no matter where they go. We need to increase education awareness among our schools and our workplaces where sickler absences are often stigmatized and seen as a sign of laziness instead of illness. And I have to say, I know this point blank as someone who lives with alpha thalassemia trait and various chronic health issues, GI specific. We must recognize sickle cell as a disability because 90% of ODSP applicants with sickle cell are denied the first time. Yes. It is a great shame. I am honored, and I tell you honored, to stand with Ulysse, with Alvin, and with the Sickle Cell Awareness Group of Ontario. And I say the full name as opposed to the acronym because we need to keep sickle cell on the agenda. As you all know, the government has time allocated Bill 74. That means there is no more conversation, debate has been closed, consultation is not happening. I am here to let you know, as your MPP for Toronto St. Paul's and your culture critic, along with your health critic, Franz Gilanis, who met with the organization today, that we are determined to stand shoulder to shoulder with you to get these asks done. Because sickle cell, there's no more time to wait. There is no more time to wait. Thank you very much. It's an honor to be here.